thousand miles and the heavens open every time you smile. And when I come to you, that's where I belong. Yet I'm running to you like a river song. You give me love, 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 love. Humor when I'm feeling low down. When I come to you, when the sun goes down, take away my trouble, take away my grief, take away my heartache in the night like a thief. You give me love, love, love.
To welcome Fallon, who's accompanied by her father Ian and by Keris, Chloe, Evan, Pearl and Alexandra. On behalf of Elliot and Fallon, I'd like to welcome you all to Bradbourne House, which has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriage. My name is Victoria, and together with my colleague who's just inside, it's our pleasure to be with here with you on this special day to conduct and register your ceremony. You've all been invited here to celebrate with Elliot and Fallon, to witness their marriage and the promises they'll make to one another. Marriage is a commitment for life, in which people can find and bring out the best in each other. When two people promise to love and care for each other in marriage, they create a union unique to themselves, which binds them closer than any spoken or written word. The legal declarations and vows that Elliot and Fallon make today will join their lives and are based on the love they share. I'd like to ask who presents Fallon to be married to Elliot.
I do.
Thank you very much, Ian. Have a seat.
Thanks.
Thank you. Would you like to have a seat with you? Married. Before you are joined in marriage, I have to remind you both of the solemn and binding character of the vows you're about to make. Marriage in this country is the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. But more than this, marriage is also intended to provide the love, friendship, help and comfort that we all need in our lives. So if there is any person present who knows of a lawful impediment why Elliot Bernard Pearson and Fallon Jade Granville may not be joined in matrimony, you should declare it now. So I would like to ask Christian to come forward, please, who has a coming chosen, especially for Fallon and Elliot.
I've got something here which is listed as anonymous, but I believe it may have been written by Mark Twain. It's entitled, These I Can Promise. I cannot promise you a lifetime of sunshine. I cannot promise riches, wealth, or gold. I cannot promise you an easy pathway that leads away from change or growing old. But I can promise all my heart's devotion, a smile to chase away your tears of sorrow, a love that's ever true and ever growing, a hand to hold in yours through each tomorrow.
Thank you very much. Thank you. The promises you're about to exchange serve as a declaration of the love you have for each other. It's not just the words you speak today which will unite you, but the sense of love and devotion that you feel within your hearts. A good partner in a marriage will not only be loving and caring, but also a true friend. Elliot and Fallon, are you both ready to make your commitment to each other?
We are.
Elliot, do you take Fallon to be your lawful wedded wife? Do you promise to be not only her husband, but also her best friend, to be loving and faithful to her to the rest of your life?
I do.
Thank you. Fallon, do you take Elliot to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you promise to be not only his wife, but also his best friend, to be loving and faithful to him for the rest of your life?
I do.
I do solemnly declare
that I know not,
that I know not
of any lawful impediment,
of any lawful impediment,
why I, Elliot Bernard Pearson,
why I, Elliot Bernard Pearson,
may not be joined in matrimony,
may not be joined in matrimony,
to Fallon Jade Granville,
to Fallon Jade Granville.
Lovely, Fallon. Please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare,
I do solemnly declare
that I know not,
that I know not
of any lawful impediment,
of any lawful impediment,
why I, Fallon Jade Granville,
why I, Fallon Jade Granville,
may not be joined in matrimony,
may not be joined in matrimony,
to Elliot Bernard Pearson,
to Elliot Bernard Pearson.
Will you repeat after me and say to Fallon,
I call upon
these persons here present,
these persons here present,
to witness that I, Elliot Bernard Pearson,
to witness that I, Elliot Bernard Pearson,
do take thee, Fallon Jade Granville,
do take thee, Fallon Jade Granville,
to be my lawful wedded wife,
to be my lawful wedded wife.
Fallon, if you repeat after me and say to Elliot,
I call upon
these persons here present,
these persons here present,
to witness that I, Fallon Jade Granville,
to witness that I, Fallon Jade Granville,
do take thee, Elliot Bernard Pearson,
do take thee, Elliot Bernard Pearson,
to be my lawful wedded husband,
to be my lawful wedded husband.
A wedding ring is an ancient and traditional way of sealing a marriage, as it's a circle with neither a beginning nor an end. It's an outward sign to everyone of the promises you've made here today. And hold it there and say to Fallon,
with this ring,
I join my life with yours.
I join my life with yours.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
I promise to respect and cherish you.
I promise to respect and cherish you.
And be faithful always.
And be faithful always.
There we go. Push it all the way on. Lovely. Would you like to take Elliot's ring? And place it on the third finger of his left hand, please, and hold it there and say to Elliot,
with this ring,
I join my life with yours.
I join my life with yours.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
I promise to respect and cherish you.
I promise to respect and cherish you.
And be faithful always.
And be faithful always.
Thank you very much, Evan. That was a brilliant job. Well done. You can have a seat again.
That's fine.
Thank you.
Thanks, mate.
So now I'd like to ask Tracy to come forward, who has a lovely poem for us.
This is called Yes, I'll Marry You, My Dear. Yes, I'll marry you, my dear, and here's the reason why. So I can push you out of bed when the baby starts to cry. And if we hear a knocking and it's creepy and it's late, I hand you the torch, you see, and you investigate. Yes, I'll marry you, my dear. You may not apprehend it, but when the tumble dryer goes, it's you that has to mend it. You have to face a neighbour should the Labrador attack him. And if a drunkard fondles me, well, it's you that has to whack him. Yes, I'll marry you, my dear. You'll be virile and you'll lean. My house is like a pigsty, you can help to keep it clean. That sexy little dinner, which you serve by candlelight, as I do chipolatas, you can serve it every night. It's you who has to work the drill and put up curtain trap. And when I've got PMT, it's you who gets the flak. I do see great advantages, but none of them for you. And so before you see the light, I do.
May you always be able to confide in each other, support each other's hopes and dreams, and laugh with one another. From this moment, you've created an understanding between the two of you that no one can break. We all hope that your love, trust and understanding of each other will continue to bring you both contentment and joy in your life together and remain constant through the years. Elliot and Fallon, you've given your marriage vows and promises to each other in front of everyone here, and it's my greatest pleasure to announce that you are now husband and wife. Would you like to have a kiss?
I had a dream so big and loud, I jumped so high, I touched the clouds. Whoa. I stretched my hands out to the sky, we danced with monsters through the night. Whoa. I'm never gonna look back. Whoa. I'm never gonna give it up. No, please don't wake me now.
2, 3, 4.
I'd like to take this formal opportunity to welcome Elliot to our family, and I've got to say that when I first met Elliot, I liked him, and then I met him some more, and I liked him some more, and then I met him some more, and I liked him a lot. And from me to you, Elliot, thank you very much for making my daughter very, very happy. Saying that, this never nearly happened today, because when I went into the changing room and saw my daughter just finishing off, and I looked and I thought, I can't give it away. There's no way I'm going to give it away. She's coming home. So it never nearly happened, but she twisted my arm and I changed my mind back. So here we are. Ian already opened and said, I'm the proudest man in the room today, and that's the understatement of the year. I can't reiterate today walking in and seeing my daughter in all of the glory of being a bridesmaid. I can't explain to you enough, because I don't have the words to explain enough how my insides felt. My heart just was pounding against my ribs, and I felt all size pair of ribs. But my legs went like jelly, and I just looked and I just thought, God, this is a dream. This is an absolute dream. And most of you don't know that Granvilles is a family, but we all are very close. But when my elder children grew up and left for university and left to form relationships, we had the baby left. And we formed the kind of bond that I did form in those days with my younger children. But because there was nobody else left, Val and I got very close and talked and whatever. So we have a very, very special bond that I found very difficult to share. So when Elliot come down, it was hard for me to like him. But I've done that bit, but I couldn't help but like him. But it was a bit like the old joke. You're watching your mother-in-law go over the cliff in your brand new Jag. You're thinking, Christ, I love that car, but Jesus, you know? And that's what it was like. And today, I've got to hand her over. She'll always be mine, but she's now Elliot's. And I can't think of a better man that I'd like to hand it over to. And if their relationship turns around anything like my other children's relationships, I'll be very, very happy. Very happy indeed. So, to you both, I just wish you the best in the world. I know it's going to work, because I know you both. And I don't think there's much more to say than that, because I'm getting all emotional now. And I apologise for that. But could we please be standing and give a bumper toast to the bride and groom.
Mark, thank you very much. I'm not one for speeches, as I'm sure you all appreciate. For all the people who've been saying over the last couple of days, have you prepared your speech? And I said, no, it's fine, you were right, I should prepare the speech. So, here we go. So, as Ian very kindly said, thank you. First of all, more than anything, thank you all for being here. You know, Ian touched on me brilliantly earlier, where, you know, some people here have come such a long way, and we're so pleased you're here. You haven't got a huge number of people here because we wanted the people to be here, we want to be here. So as soon as I saw the table plan when we first started doing it and I saw everyone would be here today, it was one of the highlights for me. Such a lovely room for lovely people, so thank you very, very much for coming. Also thanks to Beryl and Ian in particular, and the rest of the Grenville family and the Capons, just for welcoming into the family. You know, ever since I first came down, when I got together with Fallon, nothing but welcoming. Fantastic hosts, and I've been the victim of their hosting on a couple of occasions, which I'm grateful to come up in the speech, so thank you very much, Ian. But yeah, such a lovely family. I've completely felt absolutely welcome, and such lovely people to be around, and a great example for how I know more than that. Mum and Dave, Sanders, always there for us. So thank you very much for all you do for us. It's fantastic all the help you give us and looking after us. And thank you, Dave, in particular for looking after my mum. That's her. And there she goes. you know, we wouldn't be anywhere, obviously, in particular, without, you know, how well you look after us, and you're always there for us, and I truly appreciate that. I think I'm going to keep it quite brief. most importantly, it goes to many thanks for Fallon. When we first got together, I think there's a few people in this room who know, I think before she did, how I felt about her. You know, even without me saying anything, I think it's been incredibly transparent to everyone who's been in the same, you know, square mile as Fallon and I at the same time, that as soon as I met Fallon, I knew that there was something that just completely engaged me about her. I always knew that... I'm trying to play dodge a cliche. But yeah, there's, like I say, we've known each other for a long time now. And for the whole time I've known that, you know, I loved her, basically. So I'm so glad we're together. And most importantly as well, thank you for all the hard work for today. You know, you've worked so tirelessly for the last 18 months getting all this together. Pretty much everything you see in front of you, fans, worked for the last year and a half, getting absolutely perfect. I think she's done an incredible job. 48 hours ago, this was a builder's warehouse. You know. So there's definitely a, you know, putting a career on for her, I think, if she will change his mind. So yeah, most importantly, please raise your glasses for my beautiful wife. Just take glasses, Steve. That's me.
Hey! You know it. Who's got the wackiest family? Sitting on the fence. Who's in charge of the remote control?
Yeah!
Who's the best dancer? I expect you to prove that later on. Who has the most wandering hands? Which of you is the biggest flirt? We go through the first kiss. Who's more likely to run a red light? Who's the better singer? Longest in the jungle. Who's the bigger risk taker in your relationship? Who takes the risks? Who's most likely to get arrested? No hesitation from that. Who'll be the first to fall asleep tonight? Married, who'll be the first to say, not tonight. And finally, who do you love most in the whole wide world?